Hey everybody, we're back again. Jedi Outcast. So I've got some history with this game. This is the game that forced me to learn how to use dual analog sticks on the GameCube, personally enough. What am I quick? Yeah, that's good, but they won't matter today that we're going to get that far. Yeah, that's good. And subtitles are on. Going. Jedi Outcast is one of my favourite Star Wars games, and I think it's a lot of people's favourite. Because it's a really good Star Wars game. Third game in the Dark Forces series, following Dark Forces and Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight. Generally regarded as like the pinnacle of lightsaber combat in the series. The follow-up to this, Star Wars Jedi Knight Jedi Academy, is also well regarded, although I think in general its level design isn't considered to be quite as good. Also, it's considered to be weaker for whatever reason. But, like, take them both together, and they're both fantastic games that are well worth playing if you are into Star Wars. This game was added recently as the final batch of backwards compatible games, which I was really happy about, because for some weird reason, like, Jedi Outcast was one of the original Xbox games that wasn't even backwards compatible on Xbox 360. And it was like, what? But, like, they finally added it. And so I immediately snatched it up, because I love this game. And, like, when they announced this was coming to Switch, like, when that happened during that Nintendo Direct, I was hyped. I got it when it came out, and I was so disappointed. Because it's a basic PC port.
Preparing which, for final approach. Whatever's causing those transmissions, it's not showing up on any of
like
the
it doesn't have any of the console considerations that you would hope for. Especially AutoWave. Like this, the game is so hard to actually play because the game is essentially using a mouse input mapped to an analog stick. Which makes it so hard to actually aim. But the Xbox and GameCube versions, the GameCube version, the one I had growing up, ported by Vicarious Visions, who knew how to port games. There's a few console considerations at the time, like this cutscene isn't real time, it's very clearly an FMV that's got some horrible artifacts in on it. We're not seeing it in widescreen, yada yada. But it ends up playing better.
It's probably nothing more than a couple of soldiers telling tales around the glow lamp. But as you are the only survivors of the Valley of the Jedi incident, I thought it only.
And so, like, if you've got an Xbox and you don't play on PC, pick this up. Absolutely pick it up. It's one of the best Star Wars games.
Find out what you can. Clear out any remnant forces you encounter, and may the Force be with you.
If you have a PC and you play on PC, just pick it up on PC. Fantastic game. Alright, investigate the abandoned Imperial outpost and engage remnant forces in the area.
I think I saw someone.
This is my last day on this ship. Oh yeah, where are you moving? Sector 7 had an opening, so I applied. Not bad. Should be a quiet last day.
You know, you're gonna be in for a surprise, Titanium. A surprise that, admittedly, we're probably not gonna get to today. But, like, if you've never seen this game before, I'm not going to spoil that surprise for you. But as it is now, like, this is classic first-person shooter action. Jan, what are you doing there? Yep. Classic first-person shooter action, developed by Raven Software, who... before Activision relegated them to making Call of Duty DLC maps, was some of the best in the business. Especially when it came to using id's engines to make really good games. Like, Raven Software had kind of a reputation for working well with id Software and taking engines they made and making honestly better games with them. Or if not better games, then at least like very technically impressive games. Like, with the Doom engine, they created Heretic, which was pretty impressive for its time. And then, with the Doom engine, they went on to create Hexen.
The Remnant usually has pretty tight security. Make sure you search any officers for key cards.
They wanted to make Hexen, which... how good of a game Hexen is can be up for debate. Technically, Hexen is a very impressive game running on the Doom engine. It is unbelievably well polished and everything in a lot of its technical design. And they went on to do stuff like that with like so much of its stuff. And I bring that up because this game is running on the Quake 3 engine. And, you know, it's probably the best game running on the Quake 3 engine. Not even the Quake 3 is particularly bad. This is just better. So our buddy Lino was actually going through this series a little while back, back when he was streaming. He played through the original Dark Forces, which I think he had running on DOSBox, and gave up with Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight, because that game is such a pain to get running on modern systems.
Stay here, Jim.
Okay, I'll wait here.
And honestly, I've tried to get that game running myself. And the amount of hoops you have to jump through for it, it just really isn't worth it. The game was even released on GOG, and like, GOG usually have their stuff set up to just run properly. Like, install and bam, it's a front end to make these old games work properly. GOG's install for Jedi Knight doesn't really help a whole lot. So eventually Lino just gave up, and I can't blame him. It doesn't help either that, I never knew I could just turn this off. I've literally only just discovered that. Because I noticed the hand icon. And I can't turn it back on. Can I still blow it up? And then, like, you run because the explosion goes down the corridor. That's always how I thought you'd do that. Huh. But yeah, Jedi Knight. Interesting game. Most of its design isn't that good. The YouTube channel I've recommended before, Civ11. Actually, very recently put out a video on Jedi Knight. He did a video on the original Dark Forces a few years ago. Yeah, good man, Civi. He did a video on Dark Forces a few years ago, and then like he finally got around to doing Jedi Knight Dark Forces 2. And it really highlighted a big point of, like, it's not a particularly great game. Meanwhile, you get to this game, like, Raven Software, who did so much good stuff before, you know, they fell prey to the fate that awaits all of Activision's subsidiaries. Raven Software got to develop Jedi Knight 2 and Jedi Academy. And they are both fantastic games. Hey, Carpet. Welcome to the stream, buddy. I have played through Dark Forces, just not on stream. The only version of Dark Forces I have available to me to actually play is the PlayStation version. Oh, yeah. You tell that story, Kira. I know you've told me before, but you tell the chat that story. The PlayStation version I wouldn't regard as that bad. If not for the fact that you can't strafe and turn at the same time. So there is absolutely no circle strafing. And I think that's what breaks the game. And makes playing the PlayStation version really not fun. Because without that, like, it's just so much harder than it needs to be. Yeah, we're playing this on Xbox One via backwards compatibility because they recently put it on there, finally. It's like, you're damn right I immediately picked it up. Love this game, and the recent port from Aspyr on Switch and PS4 was just kind of shit. So wanting to play this on console, my only real choice was the GameCube version that I still own from back in the day. How do I use items? Oh, it's Y. Why didn't I think of pressing Y?
Kyle, the schematics show that the base is divided into three sections.
Yeah, this is easily like one of your best Star Wars games, but just this entire... No, I'm sorry, Mouser. This entire generation was just so good for Star Wars games. Like this and stuff like Bounty Hunter and Rogue Squadron 2. Yeah, I'll say it one more time for everybody who didn't hear me the first 20 times I said it, though. The big problem you've got with the more recent PS4 Switch port of this game is that it's a basic PC port.
Looks like an Imperial code.
Very basic PC port. With no console considerations. So you've got the issue of you're playing with a mouse mapped to an analog stick with nothing like auto aim. provided. And if you ever try, like, if you ever played PC games with a controller, and like, Steam's got that setup now where you can... Steam's got that setup where you can map keyboard and mouse functions to a controller, which is really convenient. But if you try to use that for a first-person shooter,
it's offline.
Like, it's not great. You need the auto aim for the analog stick. And so the problem you end up with in that case is the game is just so much harder to play than it should be. Like, this is a lot of fun. I'm loving this. I've not gone all the way through this game in years. I can't believe it took them so long to add it to backwards compatibility as well. Like, Jedi Academy's been on there for ages.
Terminal here, but it's encoded.
Yeah, better go back and get her. Oh, this is such a good game. It looks so good in this as well. Like, your Xbox One backwards compatibility is like, such a good thing. Like, the increased resolution and everything, it looks really nice and clean, and I love it. Hello. Hello there.
Took you long enough. Now, to break that code, get the way.
Alright, let's go. The movement feels really nice in this as well. Like, I really like it. Wait a minute.
Alright. Offline.
That's some good 2001 butt. But I think this game originally released on PC in 2001. 2002, I don't know. That should get you where you need to go. That is rock and roll.
I'm going to keep at this and see what I can find out.
Yep. Oh yeah, that's good. That's good game design. Must be a long elevator shaft. Yeah, it's just, it's such a well-designed game, and it gets better as we go. Oh, I remember where we are. There we go. Yeah, it gets better as we go. And more expansive, and like, it's just such a good game. I'm so glad it's finally on Xbox backwards compatibility. Stormtrooper just crawling out of the woodwork. I remember when this game came out as well, and like the main thing you'd hear about it was how it's so not accurate to the films. Because the stormtroopers are too accurate. Which was kind of funny. And if you play it on a higher difficulty, like those stormtroopers will tear through you. Turn those off.
Let's see some ID.
No. This was the best era of Star Wars gaming. Love it. 10 out of 10, wish we could have more games like this. Turn it on? No? Okay. This turns it on. Awesome. Oh. That wasn't too bad. Where did you come from? Ah, yeah. Good, good, good. Yeah, my recommendation for this would be, if you have an Xbox, buy it. If you have a PC, that's probably not good. If you have a PC, get it on PC if you don't already have it. Got in here. Factor. Don't need it. Factor. Don't need it. So there's that. So let's throw a save down. I think at this point, the only real advantage worth noting that PC, playing this on PC has over console is quick saving is so much faster.
What was that?
Just another day at work, Jan.
That sounds like probe droids. Oh, there they are. Looks like there's one missing. Oh, I didn't realize I was stood in an elevator. Hey, Star. No, this is before Rian Johnson had anything to do with probably anything. I'm sure I saw a shield one up here. Yeah, at this point in Star Wars history, I don't think there were Sith Lords post Return of the Jedi. Palpatine had come back in Dark Empire and had died again permanently. Palpatine had come back in Dark Empire and had died permanently. And for a while, until I think post New Jedi Order, there just weren't any Sith Lords.
What was that?
Just another day. Yeah, very much so. This is from that era of gaming, like. Didn't save, back to the start of the level for you. And Jedi Outcast is also from that period of... like, oh hey, yeah. We can have levels that take 5 minutes, or levels that will take 2 hours. And there's also that one level later on in the game, which is my least favorite. That one level where you have to be stealthy. If you get caught and somebody touches the alarm, then it's game over. Honestly, fuck that level. I got a pack of thermal detonators. There you are. Oh, I saw something. This is really my favorite era of first-person shooters as well, where an FPS could be just anything. Before, you know, every FPS had to be Call of Duty. Jeez, I can barely see that guy. I think its original release on PC was 2001. But around this time, like 2001, 2002, 2003. That room. There we go. Around this time, 2001, 2002, 2003, you had first-person shooters, like fantastic first-person shooters. Like Return to Castle Wolfenstein, which is really good. Shame they didn't put that on backwards compatibility. The Xbox version of that was really good. The Bond games were kind of, I don't know if I'd say peak, because, you know, someone's always going to argue that GoldenEye was the best and still is the best. You know, regardless of how much it's aged. Like, the Bond games were doing fantastic stuff at the time. Yep. No One Lives Forever came out around that time, which, God, if any game deserves a re-release, it's that. Okay, so blue. A box with a thing on the side. Two dots. Yeah, that's good. And green is sending dots, sending descending dots. And
ship for takeoff. I just want to check out one last area.
Just with the ship.
And that's the first level. Glad they didn't explode those while I was stood there. Thanks, Titanium. Mostly I said that though to highlight like just how long that first level was. That was about half an hour. That door was open a second ago. Yep.
Looks pretty cold in there.
Hmm. As we'll turn that off. I think I take damage if I go in there, but there is something I can do to stop that. I can't remember what it is.
Don't move.
Oh shit. You really want me to just be using the Bryar for the entire thing, Kira? Even in lightsaber.
Jeez, it's freezing in here.
Oh, that's what it is. It's not that I get take damage in here, it's that those vents will damage me. Or if I fall down here. There we go, that's what I can do. I knew there was something. But yeah, we're not going to get to the second half of the game today. Well, I streamed. I streamed Jedi Fallen Order last year for Star Wars Month. And, like, it's a fun enough game. I think overall I would probably rate it like 7 out of 10. Mostly because of its technical issues. Like, that game was a mess technically. There you go, you got a few Bryar Blaster pistol kills. But it's like I say, like, this is real, like, the peak era of Star Wars games. Well, let me tell you, Kira, I've played many Star Wars games, and this one is up there. Yeah, this is like peak Star Wars games era. You got stuff like this, and Bounty Hunter was really fun. Hey, this fucking room. Rogue Squadron 2. Original 2 Battlefront games. Even Rogue Squadron 3 is pretty good. The PC had Empire at War, which is pretty entertaining. This is when the Lego Star Wars games came out. The Episode 3 game. And don't get me wrong, there was some shit in this generation as well. It was always weird to me that, there is an Episode 2 game. It's only on Game Boy Advance. Like, that's weird to me. But that game's not very good. Oh yeah, this game can be very clutch. I don't think any of the Pod Racer games were bad. I think, like, they were all, at the very least, decent. Like, just the entire, what'd it be, like, a 10-year period, maybe, where it was just everything, like, so much of Star Wars was amazing in gaming. KOTOR and KOTOR 2, which, like, I find KOTOR boring these days, but, like, it was a good game. Oh, you mean Star Wars Masters of Terras Casa? Is that what you're talking about, Kira? Star Wars Kinect. I would have to own a Kinect and also have enough room for a Kinect. Here we go. This is what we're after. So I'm not going to stream it, Kira, but here is a direct link to the weekend one-off I did of it back when I was doing Let's Plays. That's 15 minutes of me playing Star Wars Masters of Terracassa, and I will never play it again. Mostly because I don't have anyone to play it with. Fighting games on your own are mostly boring. Honestly, I've played worse. It's not a good fighting game, but I've played worse. I think, like, if I had somebody to play it with, it'd be more enjoyable to play. Like, for the most part, it's 15 minutes of me just messing around trying to get through arcade mode a little. You want to know the fun thing, Kira? I've never properly played Sonic the Fighters. That's it. Well, like I said, when we were wrapping up Prince of Persia earlier, like, the Sonic games that are on Xbox One backwards compatibility, it's like Sonic 06 isn't on there because Sega delisted it because they're cowards and, like, just probably wouldn't let them put it on backwards compatibility. Sonic Heroes isn't on there, like the original Xbox version of Sonic Heroes, which is disappointing because I like Heroes. It has problems, but I like Heroes. But Sonic the Fighters is on there for some goddamn reason. Oh yeah, I spent 15 minutes on it. Yeah, back when I was doing, back when I did Let's Plays, alongside the stream. Back when I was doing Let's Plays alongside the stream, I was doing Star Wars Month on the stream. With Knights of the Republic and Jedi Fallen Order. And meanwhile, on my YouTube channel where I was doing Let's Plays, I was doing... The Force Unleashed and Rogue Squadron 2. But I was also, like, also doing... It's like The Force Unleashed went up on Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays, and Rogue Squadron 2 went up on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And I was also doing a thing at the time called Weekend One-Offs, of games like I wasn't going to do full playthroughs of. I'd play them for a bit of time for like the space of a single video on a weekend, usually on a Saturday. And then I don't think I'd upload anything on Sunday. But during Star Wars month, I doubled the rate of weekend one-offs, and there was one on Saturday and one on Sunday. And so, like, you take a look at that if you're interested, and there were a few that I put in there. Games that you'll probably never actually see anybody properly play. The 8-bit Star Wars games, which was kind of interesting. Star Wars The Clone Wars Republic Heroes. Masters of Terrace Carsey. Like, there were a few games that I did like that were kind of interesting. All games that I wasn't actually going to do a full playthrough of, though. Oh, back when I was doing the Let's Plays with that. And I was doing Horrorween, so I had horror games going up on the weekend. Because the two games I was doing for that, I think I only ended up doing one Horrorween. Because I did Let's Plays for a little over a year, so we only got through one October. I did The Suffering, and I can't remember what the other horror game I did was. Oh, it was Resident Evil. It was Resident Evil 2. What am I thinking, of course? What it is, it was Resident Evil 2. Was it, or was that a different time? Shit, I don't remember. I think it was RE2. Yeah. And then, like, I did The Suffering, which was fun. But for Halloween on there, like, some awful, awful horror games. And the only one I can remember doing was... Countdown Vampires. Which is this really bad Star Wars clone. It's this really bad Resident Evil clone on PlayStation. Like, people tell you tank controls are bad, and those people are fools. Because, like, Resident Evil tank controls are good tank controls. Stuff like Countdown Vampires, those are bad tank controls. Honestly, they were times. I ended the Let's Plays earlier this year, I think. Was it last year? No, it would have been last year, yeah. As I got more into the streaming and just focused on that more.
Hello?
I had some fun with it. Ended it with a full playthrough of Astral Chain, which was the longest Let's Play I did at like 62 parts. Like, goddamn, that was a long game. It was fun stuff, though. It was fun to go through and do all that stuff. And now I don't even stream as much as I do. Yeah, you do raise a fair point, though, Kira. Like, Sega was absurd about how much they were pulling in Sonic Adventure 1 and 2 at one point, and then they just stopped. Sega like Sonic Adventure 1 and 2 aren't on PS4 or Switch in any playable way. Which is really surprising. I'd probably be down for a portable version of Sonic Adventure 1. Not 2, honestly, I'm not doing Sonic Adventure 2 again. Like, you missed that last year, Kira, when we did the Sonic Marathon. I played through Sonic 1, 2, see, that's why I saved. Because I knew shit like that was probably going to happen. I played through Sonic Adventure, I played through Sonic 1, 2, CD, Sonic 3 and Knuckles, Sonic Adventure and Sonic Adventure 2. And my plan was to do Sonic Heroes as well, but Sonic Adventure 2 pissed me off that much. That was like, you know what? No, we're not doing more Sonic now. That's it, we're done. And the fucking Biolizard fight. It doesn't help that, like, I don't like Sonic Adventure 2 to begin with. Like, I'm willing to entertain arguments that the Sonic and Shadow stuff is better than the Sonic stuff in SA1. Everything else is worse. And I just really don't enjoy it. You know, I was saying earlier, though, like, eventually I do need to get back to... And do Sonic Adventure, Sonic Marathon 2, The Quickening. Which I decided will be the official name of it. It's relevant.
These are droid control consoles. Let's see what this little guy
can do. Yeah. Of course, part of the issue with the idea of Sonic Marathon 2, The Quickening, is like it's Sonic Heroes, and then like, do I want to do Shadow? And if I don't want to do Shadow, that means it's straight into 06 after that. I don't like, Unleashed isn't awful, but the Werehog sections take too long. And then there's Colors. Colors can be... Really, I suppose the biggest problem with doing Sonic Marathon 2, The Quickening, is going to be deciding what Sonic games I do and don't do. Because for Sonic 1 through... Adventure 2. Like, there's not really any relevant handheld games. Like, what, do I play the Game Gear version of Sonic 1 and Sonic 2? Like, no, if I'm gonna do that, I'll play the Master System version. Still the same without the screen crunch.
Lord Dasan, this is Admiral Fire.
Ah, Admiral Fire, how go our experiments?
As of this moment, they're not going at all. The testing facility on Cajum has been neutralized by a pair of New Republic mercenaries, and they've taken some of the crystals.
Mercenaries? Who?
Judging by their ship and the conversations our cameras picked up, I believe it was the pilot Jan Ors and her mercenary partner Kyle Katarn.
Katarn, eh? This setback could prove to be the answer to all our problems.
What else came out around that time? Sonic Triple Trouble? Sonic Pocket Adventure? Which,
I'm afraid we haven't been able to decode any more of that transmission.
Good. If I put the Valley of the Jedi behind me, so can the rest of the galaxy.
So what were the Remnant doing in that lab?
Our scientists believe that they were
trying then, like, you go forward with that and there's Sonic Advance and Advance 2 and Advance 3.
Those crystals you're holding are very much like those found in a Jedi's lightsaber.
Spast!
But that's impossible, isn't it? You can't just give people the Force with a machine, right?
Everything we know about the Force tells us that such devices are nothing but the fevered dreams of fools and madmen, Jan. But try telling that to those poor beings you found in that laboratory.
Who were they?
Colonists from Artus Prime, a remote mining world in the far reaches of the New
Republic. What else is there? Sonic Rush as well, which, you know, is probably worth doing.
Yes.
Trying to work out, like, what I'd actually do.
Receiving the transmission from Kejim. Now we fear that the colony has been captured by the Remnant.
Or worse.
Indeed. Without knowing the full extent of the Remnant's plans, or the colonists' plight, the New Republic is uneasy about sending in a full liberation force, so...
So you'd like us to sneak in, assess the situation, and call on the fleet if necessary?
Yes.
You know I don't like messing with this Force business anymore.
We'll double your usual fee.
We'll take it.
All right, I'm clear. This meteor storm gives us great cover. Everything's closed up. They'll never see us coming.
Good. The colony should be a few clicks out. I'll scout things out from the air while you head into the mine. Give me a shout when you find out what's going on.
Will do.
I think what we'll do now is we'll do this next level and then we'll call it for the night. And we'll come back to this whenever our next stream that is Sunday. Busted up probe droid.
I better try not to attract too much attention.
Concerning. There we go. Damn it. In the middle of platforming here. That was nasty. That was mean. Help me find some med packs somewhere soon. Probably a good time to save it. All right. There we go. Exactly what I was after. You? We go. Oh, that was quick. Should I count that? Yeah, this is so much more playable than the Switch port. So good. Don't look like anything. Yep. Can't break that. Nope, going down. Probably something I want, isn't it? You know what? I like that you can call the elevator back in mid-transit. So many games would just make you wait for it while it goes all the way back up. I have one supply key and one security key. He's holding a thermal detonator. Can I get down there? No? Alright, I guess I'm going back. Alright. Hello. There's nothing. It's a big room to have nobody in it. Should have been a little quicker on that uptake. That was my bad. Oh god, I forgot this is the level with the bloody tunnels. Tunnels aren't even the problem, it's what's in the tunnels. Like a control room like this shouldn't be empty. Oh, there we go. No, that's actually quite an ambush. Well played. Gotta give him credit. Oh, back to. Ooh. I'm gonna need to call the car. Now there are stormtroopers out. Right. That was weird. The game just froze for a second. I was a little worried there. Also getting kind of low on health. You got it, it's safe, definitely. Never know what's going to turn out to be a bad idea. Probably don't want to touch that. Ah, I know where that is. Yep. Okay, so not down there, not yet at least. Alright. See where this goes. That leads to that room. There's something I can deal with here now. Need to come back here then. This is something you just don't get with first person shooters. It's kind of like, what do I do? Where do I go? Like, as everything became like a linear corridor. Because, you know, Call of Duty did it. Remember when first person shooters could have puzzles and stuff? Areas to just explore. Okay, it's locked. This leads to that control room. There'll be a switch, I've missed. Just a camera feed, right? Oh, hello. I went this way. What are you doing here? Hmm. Yeah, I'll take those, thank you. Missing something. What am I missing? Cripple the mining opera. Tunnels. Why go through tunnels? Am I missing a tunnel? Is that what it is? Be paying attention for that. Gonna get through there. That isn't open. What am I missing? Is there anything I can do out here? Is there anything I can do in there? Okay, not that way. Check this again. Huh. That's gotta open up then. They heat whatever comes through on the cargo container. Vent it through here. Okay, that doesn't open up. I think I broke it. Awesome. Just as simple as that. And the clue to show me that I could shoot those was that one of them was sparking. The goal. I do want to get on top of it. Progress. And that leads into the tunnels.
I have a bad feeling about
that. Yeah, me too, which is why I'm a safe. Yeah, these little bitey fuckers. The best way I've found to deal with them is to hit them with the stun baton. You could also try shooting them though. Last time I did this was on the Switch, so I was shooting them without auto-aim, so it wasn't going to hit at all. Doing it with auto-aim might work out better. Alright. Batteries. Batteries. They're not dawdle.
What's this? Looks like the remnant are using slave labor.
Yeah. All right. Good place to save it. Alright. Can I make it to that? I survived. Yes. Fun keeping on. I feel like there has to have been a better way down. Yeah, that'd be it. Oof. There's only one way up. I'm low on ammo. Yup. That is not giving me enough ammo. Looks like a weapon rack over there though, so that hopefully did some good. A lot of people there. The guy hadn't even noticed. Somehow made it. Wonder what this button does.
Mon Mothma was right, Jan. Remnant troops are crawling all over this place and they've taken prisoners.
Well, that should bring the Republic running. I'll alert the fleet and pick you up.
Go ahead and call in the reinforcements, but I've got a mine to blow up and prisoners to rescue.
Are you trying to justify your fee?
Be ready for a quick pickup. I've got a feeling that things are about to get pretty nasty around here.
Who needs the Valley of the Jedi when you're already gifted with such amazing intuitive powers?
Just be ready to pick me up.
As you wish, O Jedi Master.
Thank you.
Jan, this place is about to fall apart. If I don't find a way out, you'll have to get help.
Just get out of there, Kyle.
Okay. Gentlemen. Yeah, it didn't explode like I was expecting. Others? No? Alright. Looks like the exit's blocked. Hopefully the tram is there. Hello. Oh, those things got out. Yeah, you guys can deal with those. No, I should probably kill you all, shouldn't I? There we go. Now everybody's happy. Ah, crap. Yeah, we're all good. Out of here. Alright, so save it here and we'll pick up next time, I guess. Yeah, so that's going to do it for us for today. I want to thank everybody for joining the stream. Really appreciate the support. Big special thank you to everybody in the chat. Chat is always the best part of the stream. The Titanium, Kira, Star, Carpet, and Teak. In the stream. No, I don't like Teak was in the stream, but thanks to Teak for showing up earlier anyway. And like super special thank you to Titanium for keeping me company for most of the day while I've been streaming. Like, very much appreciate. Really what kept me going earlier on. Streams. Not sure when we'll be back. Might be back tomorrow. Depends how I feel after work. Because I'm back in work tomorrow. But we'll be back definitely on Sunday. As Chansom and I continue Persona 3 FES. So look forward to that. It should be fun. But in the meantime, thank you all for watching. Have yourselves a fantastic time of day. And take care. Catch you next time, guys. Bye.